Welcome all to yet another video, Dr. RS and you, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. We are in part 45 today, Vanishing Cream. So, Vanishing Cream. Part 45, right? History of Vanishing Cream. Vanishing cream, originally called as stearate cream, we will see why, were more commonly called as vanishing cream because they seem to disappear when spread on the skin. Boros Welcome, who began selling the stearate cream called Hazeline Snow in 1982. The name Vanishing Cream, probably coined by Pond's Extract Company, who began making stearate cream and branded as Pond's Vanishing Cream in 1904. Then Erasmic Vanishing Cream was launched. Right. What is unique in the Vanishing Cream? White pearly appearance of the cream, very attractive. White pearly appearance of the cream impart dry matte feel to the skin. Mask oily look on the face. Currently, the winning cream base for anti-blemish creams, especially in Southeast Asia and Middle East. It's also a good makeup base. So makeup applied after applying vanishing cream, the makeup stays for a longer time. Right? These are the uniqueness of vanishing cream. Vanishing cream broadly, the skeleton of the vanishing cream formula is stearic acid is the main oil phase. Potassium hydroxide and water, of course, the water effect. So this is the skeleton of a vanishing cream base, right? So stearic acid is melted in the face vessel, right? Stearic acid is melted in the face vessel. In the main kettle, you have water, potassium hydroxide solution, stearic acid added. 75 to 80 degrees centigrade water phase, 75 to 80 degrees centigrade oil phase added to water phase, right? As soon as all the oil phase added, mixed for some time and then homogenized, then cooled at 45 degrees, you can perfume and preservatives are added, right? So, this is how the cream is made. What is the emulsifier for the cream? The emulsifier for the cream is soap, right? Because stearic acid reacts with potassium hydroxide to form potassium stearate. Potassium stearate is formed in situ while the emulsion is formed. That's what we discussed in the previous thing also, preparation of emulsions. We said some emulsifiers are formed in situ. So this is potassium stearate is formed. So if you take the molecular weight of stearic acid used, because it's not a pure stearic acid, it's a combination of stearic and palmitic, which we will discuss subsequently. So we will take the molecular weight of stearic acid 270. 56.1 is the molecular weight of potassium hydroxide, KOH, stearic acid. Now we are adding 0.5, how much stearic acid it will react, right? So around 2.4 grams of stearic acid, right? It will react. So when you use 0.5% sodium hydroxide, it will react with about 2.4 grams of stearic acid. The remaining stearic acid will form the oil phase, right? The oil phase. So that is how the vanishing cream is made. At 45 to 50 degrees, you add the perfume and preservative. This is how the cream is made, and this is the calculation, right? So we will see two important things here. Stearic acid, since it's the main oil phase, we will go into the depth of stearic acid and the quality of stearic acid that should be used for vanishing cream. Potassium hydroxide, you have to be very careful. Potassium hydroxide is always available in 85% purity. Right? Potassium hydroxide always 85% purity. So when you design the formula, you have to be very clear. 0.5, because you have to say 0.5, you are using 85% purity. 0.5 means 100, for it to be 100% pure, how much you require? Right, you might require little more. Right, so this is 0.5 of 100% pure potassium hydroxide. So that is what you have to calculate. 100 by 85 into 0.5. So you will require 0.59% of 85% potassium hydroxide right here. That is equivalent to 0.5% of 100% potassium hydroxide. So you have to calculate, because potassium hydroxide maximum purity you get 85% purity. That you have to take into account. Now we will come to stearic acid, right? Stearic acid, the quality of stearic acid that is used in vanishing cream is triple press stearic acid. Triple press stearic acid has very, very low level of oleic acid. Oleic acid is an unsaturated fatty acid. When oleic acid is present, the rancidity is set in. So the stearic acid with a very, very low level of oleic acid is supposed to be high quality stearic acid for cosmetic use, and that is called triple pressed stearic acid, right? With iodine value less than 1, very preferable. Iodine value is the measure of unsaturated fatty acid present, that we said we studied in the fats and oils thing. So oleic acid present can be detected by the iodine value. If the iodine value is high, then oleic acid content is high, then the stearic acid is prone to rancidity. So triple press stearic acid, where the iodine value is less than 1, which confirms the oleic acid content. Then ratio of palmitic acid and stearic acid. When palmitic acid and stearic acid in the ratio is different, because always stearic acid comes with palmitic acid, right? It's not pure stearic acid. Stearic acid and palmitic acid comes together. So at various proportions, the melting point is different, solubility is different, X-ray dry fraction is different, and the crystal and structural differences is very revealing, on the various palmitic acid and stearic acid ratio, right? For example, reference Cosmetic Science and Technology, Balsam and Saccharin, volume 1, from here, it is given here. So when it is 100% palmitic acid, the crystal size of the material is like this. If it is 70-30, the size reduces, crystal size. 55-45, this is, the size starts increasing. 50-50, the size is totally different. Then again 65-35, this it's very grainy, small size. Then slowly the sides, it start increasing. 20 palmitic, 80 stearic, and 100 stearic, this thing, the particle size looks totally different of stearic acid, right? So now, what is the stearic acid that has to be used for vanishing cream? Actually, we call it stearic acid, but the ideal stearic acid quality that has to be used for vanishing cream is this combination, 55% palmitic and 45% stearic. This gives good pearly cream with good consistency, right? Other combination, especially these two combination, gives a very, very soft cream, right? Triple press stearic acid. Triple press stearic acid ends up having 55% palmitic and 45% stearic. So when you decide stearic acid for your vanishing cream, you have to specify this. It has to be iodine value less than 1, and it should be 55% palmitic and 45% stearic. Actually, the molecular weight of stearic acid is more than 280. I took 270 in the calculation before, because whatever we use will be a combination of stearic and palmitic, right? Palmitic acid molecular weight is around 260, right? So most important thing is stearic acid for vanishing cream is not pure stearic acid, but it is a combination of 55% palmitic acid and 45% stearic acid. This is the ideal combination for vanishing cream to get the consistency and pearliness of the cream, right? So what happens? The vanishing cream, the structure of the vanishing cream, it's totally different. As we were discussing about the theories of emulsification, we talked about fatty alcohol surfactant system, gel phase, gel networks. So here also, stearic acid with soaps forms gel phase and gel networks, and it is very unique in vanishing cream. So when you see this cream, vanishing cream, they are stable at around 40 to 50 degrees, right? When the temperature of storage is less than 10 degrees, they tend to thin down, right? So unique cream is when the temperature is very low, the cream start thinning down. So ideally 40 degrees, very good for this cream. It maintains the consistency very well. Tendency of the cream to dry and turn into flakes. If the container is not properly closed, it can dry out and form flakes, right? Stearic acid flakes. Stability and sensory can be enhanced further. So how these can be addressed in modern creams? Actually, this is the skeleton of the cream. 16 to 20% stearic acid, potassium hydroxide, water to 100%, preservatives and perfume, right? Now, cetyl alcohol at 0.5% can be added to the formula that can stabilize it further. Then emollients like isopropyl myristate, isopropyl palmitate, emollient esters, dimethicones at less than 1% can be added to the product, but not to a higher level, because it should not affect the dry matty feel of the product. You have to be little careful. Humectants are very, very important. What are humectants? Humectants are not only moisturizers, but also prevent the product from drying, right? So stearic acid as the is very unique, that if it kept open for some time, it dries and forms flakes. So humectants should be incorporated in the formula, right? So 2% glycerin is ideal. If you increase glycerin to higher levels, at lower levels it works very well, at higher levels it tend to thin down the formula, right? So propylene glycol also you can use at higher level. Rheology modifying agents, you can use other rheology modifying agents also at low levels, like carbamers, you can use at a very low level to stabilize further, right? But when you add all these things, all the other excipients, you have to take care that the pearliness is not affected. Sometimes higher levels of emollients, right, can affect the pearliness. Same way, higher level of rheology modifying agents can alter the sensory and also kill the pearliness of the cream. So you have to do trials, but very important here is humectant. Humectant is very important. A low level of cetyl alcohol is also okay, but adding emollient esters and rheology modifying agents, it has to be done in a careful way so that you get that pearliness right, no? Consistency and pearliness right. So of course the actives, right? The actives are added. So mostly the products for skin blemishes, and as such the base, vanishing cream as a base itself is very good to give a bright look to the face, oil free matte look to the face. It gives an oil free matte look to the face, so in that case it's very good, right? And it, as we discussed, it's a good makeup base. And actives for, especially for skin blemishes, can be introduced in this. Low level of sunscreens work in this base very well. So what are the limitations of using vanishing cream as a base for cosmeceuticals, right? Vanishing cream is unstable at low pH. Ideally, a pH of 7 to 7.5, it is very stable, right? When the pH is reduced, if it goes below 5, pH below 5, it will start separating, because soap is the emulsifier. Soap at lower pH will start dissociating, so the its emulsifying property is lost. So pH, so when the actives tend to bring down the pH of the cream, you can't use that active, because at low pH this base is not compatible. This base is not stable. And electrolytes, any electrolyte will salt out the soap. When it salt out the soap, of course, soap will be not there be in the, at the interface. So it will cause the emulsion instability and it can crack the cream. So vanishing cream is an excellent base for actives, but it has limitations. Very few actives can be used in a vanishing cream base environment. So there was a search for creams with low pH, compatible with electrolytes and low other actives, but still have a vanishing cream type of sensory, right? The patent has been filed by Unilever, right? This is the patent. Low pH, high skin friction cosmetic creams. I'm one of the authors for the patent. So this is the cream where you can use it with all actives, but still retain the sensories of a vanishing cream, right? So it doesn't have soap as an emulsifier. See, the uniqueness of this cream is, when you use some other emulsifier with the same level of stearic acid, the sensory is totally lost, right? Soap and stearic acid is very unique for this cream, but using some other emulsifier and bringing back the sensories of a vanishing cream and still make it stable with wide range of pH and the and with electrolytes, no, it was a challenge, right? So this is what I want to share with you on vanishing cream. Please write to me when you want to discuss more about this, because the time is restricted. I see that people, if the individual video is more than 15 minutes, even 15 is high, 15 minutes, it's people become restless. So I'm trying to restrict it. I'm giving the broad ideas, broad details, but if you want to get into finer details, you can write to me, we can discuss on it, if I could help you or I will learn from you. Thank you for listening to me patiently, and until we get in touch with the next part 46, bye to you all. Be happy, be smiling, be safe. Thank you.